Hey guys, welcome to Outlaw Edge. So, I've been trying to mess with this thing with Rogue today, getting frustrated with it, so taking a break, figured I'd do a video for Iron Horse Garage. If you guys haven't checked out Iron Horse Garage's channel, go check them out. They're good people, good guys. A bunch of goofballs, and they're in Idaho, and you know, they just did a Volkswagen project a while back, and hopefully soon they'll be getting on another project. They have like some, you know, a lot of Dodge cars, and one of the trucks they were doing, I can't remember what the name of the truck is called, like a Villager or a something. You guys know what I'm talking about, but they're putting like a big Cummins truck motor in it, which is crazy, but pretty cool channel. They do, you know, some nice fabrication and bodywork and all that kind of stuff. I think you guys really like the channel. But they challenged me, or not challenged me, I wouldn't say that. They did a video and kind of did like a shout out or whatever for me and Glenn Ridd. And then it's called The One That Got Away. And they're talking about like a car that they got, you know, back in the day that they wish they still had, or something happened and the car ended up getting away. You know, like William was saying in his video on Iron Horse Garage, he was saying that, you know, he went to buy another car and, or buy a motor for a car, and at the time he had the cash and didn't buy the car of his dreams, and then that car ended up getting away because he had to buy the motor for that other car. If I had to go back and, you know, think about the ones that got away or whatever, there's a couple of them, but one of the ones that really got me when I was growing up, well, I mean, I never really grew up, but when I was younger, I was probably 13 years old, maybe 14 at the most, and I saved up all summer long. And I asked this lady that lived in this old house. She was about probably 3/4 of a mile down from us, and I used to go down there every day after school and look at this car. And it was a black, it was a 49, I think it was a Dodge Wayfarer or Plymouth, whatever. I don't remember. I think it was a Wayfarer though, but it was this beautiful, gangster looking car, gangster white walls, fender skirts. It sat low, it looked mean, and I just fell in love with that car. And you know, it kind of bummed me out because I tried real hard to get the car, and that ended up going on for about a year. And I mean, I to the point where I was like begging these people, could I please like work all summer long for the car, or could I pay you for it or whatever? And they were kind of wealthy people, so they never really wanted it and whatever. And so one of the younger kids, I'm thinking it was like their son was there one day, and I stopped by and I was on my bicycle and talking to the guy, and I said, hey, I'd really like to buy that car if there's any way I could buy it. And the old lady recognized me. She says, yeah, he's been coming here, you know, for the last year or whatever, and asked me about the car. And like I said, I was just completely in love with this car. I wanted it so bad because I wanted to you know, fix it up and drive it around or whatever. And I had all these magazine clippings out of like that style car. And I had, you know, like, you know, chopped the tops on them and lowered them and put, you know, custom wheels on them and did all these, like, you know, back in the day when you didn't have Photoshop, you had magazines. So you cut up all your magazines and do that. And I had just piles of magazines in my room with that car on it, or that style car on it, with a bunch of different modified pictures that I'd cut up, you know, cut up. And you know, so I had big dreams for this car and big plans for this car. So the old lady, long story short, the old lady was at the house. She recognized me. She told the son, you know, he wants that thing pretty bad, and I don't think we'll ever do nothing with it. And the guy, the son, was like, Mom, we'll never do nothing with this car. Go ahead and sell it to him. And she said, I think they wanted like $1,300 for it or something. It was, at the time, I mean, that was a lot of money for me being 13, 14-year-old kid, you know. And I was like, oh, I can't do that much money. And they're like, well, how about $800? We agreed on $800. And at the time I had like $600 saved up or something. And so I told them, well, I'm gonna go work my butt off. I'm gonna try to get that money. And I had some side jobs that I could do, mowing and doing all kinds of stuff through the rest of the summer, I guess it would have been. And so they were like, yeah, we'll agree on it. So we shook hands on it. Well, my thing is when you shake hands on a deal, it's a done deal. That's how I was raised. It was like, when you shake hands, it's a done deal, the deal's over, you know, there's no turning back or whatever. And that didn't happen. But I shook hands on the car, and they agreed that they'd sell it to us for, I think it was like $800, whatever, because like I said, I had 600. And so I left. I worked for the rest of the summer to get that car. Like 3 days before I had enough money to get that car, I had a couple jobs lined up where I was going to have the money and in like 3 days go over there and pick it up. And I remember hearing fire engines go by. And the house, it was on the corner of Jack Tone and Tokay Colony. And that house burnt to the ground. And the car was like literally right next to the house, so that there was nothing left. And it wrecked me. I was destroyed. I was like, man, you know, and never seen another one that clean like that after that. You know, I mean, the thing was beautiful. And it sucked because when the son was there, he was telling me, oh yeah, my dad's had it running and stuff. The thing runs. And you know, if we aired up the tires and whatever, you could drive it around or whatever. So I was like so excited, but it just devastated me. And that was like one of them deals where, you know, like the guys on Iron Horse Garage were talking about, they said, you know, what is the one car that got away? That would have to be that car right there. There's been some other ones, you know, that happened, but that one, man, it just messed me up. It wrecked me. But anyways, if you guys haven't had a chance to go check out Iron Horse Garage, go check their channel out. They got some really good content on there, and I noticed they're getting a lot of subs, and their channel's starting to grow a lot. Hoping to see some projects from them soon, and you know, go over there and check out their channel, and I think you guys will really like it. But anyways, I appreciate all the comments and support and everything with our channel. Recently, we just hit 30,550 subs, which just blows me away. And I can't thank you guys enough. We're trying to get Rogue done, but right now it's really hard because it seems like every time I put a welding helmet on or gloves on and earplugs in, literally every 10 minutes there's somebody beating on the door. And I'm to the point where I'm going to just open the door and smash people in the face. It just gets old, you know. Heidi's laughing at me. But yeah, it just, after a while, it gets really aggravating. You know, you spend, you know, 8 hours in the shop and you end up getting an hour worth of work done. And you're, half the time you don't get that done because you're trying to hurry up and get caught up from the stuff that you were trying to do earlier. But it's just frustrating. But anyways, Iron Horse Garage, go check them out. Thanks for watching, you guys. Later.